You've been hearing a lot about measles in the news lately, and I'd like to tell you a little bit why immunologists such as myself get really worried when we hear about measles outbreaks. I'm Dr. Don Bowdish, and I'm a professor of medicine at McMaster University. Measles is far from a harmless childhood infection. In fact, in the pre-vaccine, pre-antibiotic era, measles killed more people than influenza. It is still the top killer of all the vaccine-preventable infections in the world today. The reason measles is so dangerous is, unlike influenza or RSV or other respiratory infections, it doesn't infect our lungs per se, it infects our immune cells. It also kills those immune cells, and with them die our immune memory, all the immune responses we've built up to all the things we've experienced in our life. As a consequence, when a child has measles, they have a period of what we call immune suppression, where they become very vulnerable to other bacterial infections. Now, most of the time, those can be treated with antibiotics, so in Canada, deaths are rare. But we also know that when those immune cells are killed from the measles virus, they don't always come back. And so children who've had measles can have more infections and need more antibiotics for up to 5 years after that first measles infection. One of the reasons measles is really problematic is it can cause lots of problems for both mom and baby during pregnancy. In the late 1990s and early 2000s, there was an anti-measles misinformation campaign. And consequently, there are a lot of young adults who are now thinking about starting their families who haven't been vaccinated for measles. If you haven't been vaccinated, it's easily fixed. Our National Advisory Council on Immunization recommends that anyone at any point in their life who hasn't been vaccinated should get a vaccine. However, if you're planning on getting pregnant, it's important to get vaccinated prior to pregnancy because we don't give pregnant women the measles vaccine. You can look up the National Advisory Council on Immunization, talk to your family doctor, or look up the rules in your public health unit if you have any concerns that you haven't been vaccinated. It's going to be really important that we all keep up to date with all our vaccines, but especially measles because it's so contagious. If we don't, there may be outbreaks in places like cancer centers, or people who have immune conditions that require them to be on immunosuppressants. We need to protect the vulnerable people in our community by making sure we're all up to date with our vaccines.